The Philippine government is moving to curb the selling of unregistered vape products. The Trade Department said Wednesday, stores selling the unlicensed products will be apprehended beginning September. An official of the agency's consumer protection group says this should give manufacturers and importers the time to ensure their vape products are registered. The Trade Department previously said confiscated illegal vape products amounted to 31 million pesos in April. It now urges local governments and the private sector to help raise awareness on the dangers of using vape. Just last month, the Philippines reported its first known death of a minor from a severe lung injury from the use of such products. Despite prospects of an early rate cut from the BSP, HSBC Global Private Banking and Wealth believes the Banco Central would cut rates in the fourth quarter after the Fed has already cut its own benchmark rate. The firm attributes its forecast to the stable Philippine economy and inflation remaining at the upper end of the government's 2-4% target range.
In the second quarter of this year, the peso has already become the worst performing Asian currency. And this is more driven by market expectation of potential early rate cut by the BSP, because this this may have an impact on the interest rate differential. But we actually think that the BSP has no need to hurry to cut interest rate. The market currently speculate there could be a rate cut by the BSP in August. We expect the rate cut will actually come in Q4 because economic growth in the Philippines remains strong. So there's no urgency for the central bank to cut interest rate. On the other hand, the May CPI inflation of the Philippines came in at 3.9%. This actually came in at the upper end of the central bank inflation forecast range. So this also underpins our expectation that the BSP will likely stay patient and wait until Q4.
Philippine lawmakers urge the Marcos administration to demand justice and reparation for the Philippine Navy soldiers who suffered injuries as a result of China's aggression. Congressman Edsel Lagban says the government should demand the full identities of the culprits. Lagban also wants Beijing to be held accountable. For Congressman Robert Ace Barbers, the Philippines should arrest trespassers in its territorial waters.
Kapag sila ay pumasok o nag-trespass sa ating teritoryo, dapat manghuli rin tayo. Hulihin din natin sila. Dahil isang pagpapakita ito ng pagrespeto sa ating mga pulisya at ating batas dito sa ating bansa.
The Philippine Coast Guard maintains its presence in the waters of Bao de Masinloc as China implements its anti-trespassing policy. The PCG says it will ensure the safety of Filipino fishermen amid the arrest threat. Beijing effectively implemented last June 15 a regulation allowing the Chinese Coast Guard to detain foreigners accused of illegally entering China's so-called maritime features. The Philippines has called the policy a threat to regional peace and security.